There are a lot of people who are taking over from the builder. Resident welfare associations have been formed and a lot of them are taking over from the builder, but they don't really know what needs to be taken over and what are the pitfalls that one may face. Mr. Prakash, can you take us through a couple of things that are pitfalls that resident welfare associations should be aware of?
First of all, the resident welfare association should be very clear about two things. One is technical, another is legal. Legal contains the papers connected with the land and whatever is the clearances that are required from various authorities. For example, they should have what's called a commencement certificate. They should have statutory clearances by the fire authorities. You should have clearances given by the the pollution control board. They should also have occupancy certificates, so on and so forth. I'm sure, Suresh, you have got something else to say or add on to this.
Yes, sir. These are the documents what are required before they take over. So, legal part usually will be handled by a lawyer who are experienced in these things. And technical part, we can guide them on whether the things have been built as per the sanction plan and all the facilities and amenities are working as they should be. And then we can take them through the technical quality check of...
A lot of people come to us and ask us about the STP, the WTP and elevators and things like that. Can you give us a little bit of those concerns? I even remember somebody who asked us about the design audit. Can you explain that to us, please?
Yeah, many times they are not very confident whether the STP provided, does it have adequate capacity?
By STP, you mean the sewage treatment?
Yes. Sewage treatment plant provided has the capacity to take all the output that comes out of the apartment complex, whether it has been designed to handle that capacity. So that part needs to be
so checked. What is
not necessarily a sewage treatment plant alone. There are a lot of people who come and ask us about the structural stability also. They are concerned about the structural stability. Most of the builders go through what is called a proof check done by another third party. Probably they could ask for that and make sure that they have the document where the proof check of the whole structure is done, and they could request from the builder and he could probably submit them to it so that they can keep it as a piece of document.
What is a design audit? A lot of them have asked us for a design audit. Can somebody explain to us what a design audit is?
Most of the time, the design audit confines to the structural stability audit. Not much to do with the other things like the electrical or plumbing or so. But I think a lot of them are concerned about the structural stability itself. So there is what's called a structural stability certificate given by the structural designer. So they could ask for that and they could retain that as a part of their document and then they keep it in their library, and which is very valid. And the other thing they could ask for how the design for the sewage treatment plant is arrived at, or their electrical system, or the basis for arriving at the water requirements, or and so forth, that would also be available with a well-established developer. He can certainly get that also.
Mr. Suresh, what about checking the common areas, the basements and things like that? Can you explain to us?
Having confirmed about the design part of it, now the functional part has to be checked whether things are as they are planned to be, like any finishing workmanship is not okay, because outside the flat, the common areas, somebody has to go through thoroughly to check whether all the, for example, the parking, whether parking has all the proper flooring done, is there any cracks, any structural cracks are observed, and then are there any dampness. Mainly the basements have got issue with the dampness, if the retaining wall is not properly constructed. So how that has to be addressed, that needs to be checked. And then coming up, then all the staircases, then the terraces, whether the terraces have been finished properly for the water outtake, the rainwater outtake, all those things need to be checked.
What about lifts?
One of the most important thing about the dampness that they should be aware of is potentially dampness in any of these places is a very dangerous one in terms of the structural stability itself, because it could lead to corrosion of reinforcement and subsequently it could also lead to spalling. And so this is one area that
I think regarding spalling, you've made another video that, yes, I think is also on YouTube.
That's there.
Yes.
So some people who want to look at it, they can see the video on spalling, which is great detail. For example, lifts, you are talking about the lifts, and if there are any lifts, that they have to make sure that the lift is, also there is a license given to run the lift. Similarly, the generator, the lift authorities also give you a clearance by the lift inspectorate saying that yes, you can operate the lift. And coming back to the functionality of the lift itself, it has to be checked whether it is operating as per the design requirement. For example, some of the lifts go at 1.25 meters per second. Does it really go at 1.25 meters?
You spoke about DGs. I believe you're talking about diesel generators. What is it that one needs to be aware of in a diesel generator? And also, firefighting is a big thing that a lot of people are concerned about.
First, regarding DG, they have to find out how much it can give a backup of. Like, for example, there is a term used, what is known as the diversity factor. In very high-end flats, they give 100% backup, where everything can run normally.
So you mean 100% means that when it goes up, they can run the AC, they can run the...
Everything. As if the electricity board supply is there, okay. They can run everything. That's a diversity factor of one. And in some cases, they may not give 100% backup. That is the builder's proclamation, what he has been assured. So based on that the aspects of how much of backup is designed and given, that needs to be checked up. And secondly, whether all the DGs come off when the power fails, and whether they are operating smoothly without any irregularities, all those things need to be checked, whether all the earthing or the connections have been done as per the procedure, that needs to be checked.
So coming to the fire authorities would have given a clearance giving the requirements that they say that you should implement in the building, so that they, it complies to the requirements of the fire authority. For example, the road that is running around the building has to be of a particular dimension. So once the you can really inspect it and make sure that they have provided as per the fire authority's requirement. Similarly, the sprinklers, the firefighting system, whether it meets all the requirement of the fire authority, including the staircase yeah. dimensions, staircase width. There is what's called a fire staircase. So they are very particular about what needs to be provided in a building to meet the fire authority requirements. So the RWA can ensure that these are all complied with by the builder before you take over from the building.
What about the jockey pump? There are certain aspects of a jockey pump that needs to come online when the...
Jockey pump is part of the firefighting system. It is always provided there. So jockey pump is only to maintain the pressure on the line all the time, even if there is a leak. So that is something that is part of the whole system. So when you come to know what that they have provided, you can, as a part of the inspection, make sure that the jockey pump is also there, which normally is there.
And there have been people who also asked us about measuring the area, the footprint of the whole construction. So we also do that. So what use is this to the RWA?
This is only to make sure that what the builder has been assuring them, saying say a particular area of a building built in a particular size of a plot. So that becomes the asset of the association once the builder moves away. So to make sure that the same quantity of asset is transferred onto them, so for example 2 acres or 2.5 acres, so the measurement of area assures that particular area has been handed over properly.
Thank you, Mr. Suresh. Thank you, Mr. Prakash. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking subscribe if you have not already subscribed. Thank you very much.